Okay, hello everyone. In this tutorial, we will be looking at how to create your basic Express app and most importantly, how to share it with others via using Localtunnel. Okay, to begin with, I have Visual Studio Code open here, which is a nice IDE. And we just create a new folder called, let's say, sample projects. And it's with VS Code. In there, we need to do a few things. First, we need to initialize our project via the npm init command. And to right there, I suggest you to open the integrated terminal by using a shortcut called Control and tilde, which opens the terminal. And inside there, as I said, just write npm init. And just a little tip, if you want to initialize it by default values, instead of just pressing enter multiple times, just pass y as an argument, and it will initialize it with default values. So if you want to change those later, you can just go to package.json file, which is created inside our project, and you can change those accordingly. So as I said, our project is based on Express.js, so we need to install that, and we do that by npm install express. There we go. We will be also using a module called ejs, which enables us to pass JavaScript variables inside our HTML, inside our view, which is not absolute necessity, but it will be nice to include that in our project. So I just install that by npm install ejs. That did install. Nice. So we need to create our views directory. And inside that directories, we need to create a file called index.ejs. Inside our ejs file, I'm not do any fancy stuff. I just add a basic HTML file, and inside that HTML file, I will be adding a simple header. And inside our header, we just pass good old hello world. And close it. We don't need to fiddle with this anymore. So we go back to our project and we create a new file called So why it keeps persisting on creating it? Okay. So inside there we just create a .js, and this is where our main logic for application will be. And first we need to initialize our npm the express module. To do that, we just use this line, not that, this, yes. And we need our app to run express, so we do that by calling the express as a function. This is a common thing to do, and we don't need any actually additional stuff. We need a basic get request for our home, and we did it by just like that. And function, we have two arguments, request and response. And to give a response to the request of home, we will be giving our ejs file, and we did do this via using the render method. And inside the render method, we give an index.ejs file as an argument. So, and also we need to create our server, and to do that we just need to app.listen and inside that we need to specify our ports, which in my case I will be just giving the AD. And after that, just a side note, if you want to get the port number by environment, you can also use process dot what is that, env dot, it should be something like that, I don't remember, so I will just use ADAD and to function. This function is not absolute necessary, but it is nice to create a console.log here to notify us that the server has been started. Okay, we shouldn't be missing anything, and we should be able to start our server now by using the command called node app.js, not JJS, JS. There we go. So if we run that, this just a call. There we go. We just created our basic Express app. Now what we have to do is to share with others. So let's say I want to share it with my friend. I really like my Hello World app. So we just open up the local tunnel. You can find more detailed stuff there. And we need to install globally in our environment. So we just close our server temporarily, and we need to install it by the following command. Let it install. Nice. So we just again run our server. Started and let's check. Yeah, it's working properly. So I just want to open a PowerShell to demonstrate. And the second command we will be using is just like in the website stated, the LT, which is local tunnel, and specifying the port that we our project is running on. So in our case it will be ADAD, so we will pass the command LT port ADAD. So it should create a link for us. Let's see. Did I do something wrong? So JS. Is our app running? Okay, so I will find the issue and come back in a second.
3 hours later.
Okay, so it turns out that our issue is caused because local tunnel servers are way too busy because they are hosted publicly. So apparently I found another solution, which is an ngrok. You just go to the ngrok.com and go to download page and download it for whatever platform you need. And after you have downloaded, you should have a zip file, and once you extract it, let's extract it here. Yeah, you should get an exe file for Windows. To run that exe, we need to open command prompt and type ngrok, and we need to specify our port by looking at there 8080. And before the port, we need to first specify the protocol we use. So in our case it's HTTP, and our port will be 8080. And before that we need to actually run our server, and there we go, it runs. So once we run that, and okay, that is because we should be on desktop, and that's interesting. So yeah, so did I miss something? ngrok http 8080, not 99, 8080. There we go, now it's running. And as you can see, it's created a URL for our application. And if I give that URL to my browser, let's check that out. There you go. We can monitor our application. And we have a public one. And that's it for our tutorial. And I hope I can help you to share your projects. And see you next time. Thank you for watching.